Hi everyone, it's Taff. Welcome back to Glenmalure on Farming Sim 2013. We're back. We're in the beautiful Iris region and it's going wonderfully. You may notice that, hey up, you've lost some of the grass off the field, lad. Yeah, I know. Believe it or not, I thought, well, I'll just get a little bit done off screen so we don't have to sit and watch all of it. I've already done two loads and look how much grass is still there. It's incredible the amount of grass we've managed to get off this field. But we'll keep going anyway. Let's just keep picking it up. And what I've done with the grass we've collected, I have just literally dropped it off into the silage bin at the yard in the farmyard, not in any of the ones near the biogas plant. No, this is all gone into the farmyard so we can use it for feed, mixed ration and the like. So that's all good stuff. Right, as that gets out, yeah, I should imagine we probably get at least another two trailers off this, to be honest with you. It's an incredible amount of grass that's come off it, which is good. It just takes a hell of a long time to collect it all up, but it's all good really. Okay, while that's doing that, should we just have a quick look? Oh, that hasn't just loaded in, so that hasn't started calculating the productivity of our animals, and I've just missed a bit of grass. It's a bit of a pain. Okay, not a problem. We'll do a really, say, tight turn, but it's not really a tight turn, and stick some more pace on and we'll go down this line. So how are things going in the farm? Really well, really well. I think everyone's in agreement that we will get this field ploughed probably on Saturday when it's raining. We'll look to get it ploughed and we'll get some crops down. Let's have a look at what the best prices of things are. So, can't drive and look at the PDA at the same time, which is one of my many flaws. So, what we got here? Barley is about 239, which is looking pretty good actually. Here we go, 200, canola 235. Okay, so probably barley or canola are the two we're going to go with. Yeah, probably canola actually. Let's get some cash crop going with old canola, because that's 235 at the bioglass plant. Actually, barley. Barley looks... Oh no, there you go. The Lodge, 511. Okay, we're going to go for canola at the Lodge. 500 per whatever it is. That's pretty damn good. We're coming up to the end of this, but what I just wanted to do is just scan to statistics. Here we go. So we've already got... We've got 10,000 litres of wheat and barley. We can always sell some of that. We've got some potatoes and that's okay. That's fine. Cow's own 10... Liquid manure, 22222, all the twos. Is that almost full? Almost full. And they are doing okay feed wise as well. I'm trying to do two things at once. I'm really not the multitasker I thought I was. Right, let's just set you going down that straight line. So food wise, they are doing okay. They've got 16,000 litres of grass. They got some straw and they've got milk. Okay, they're producing milk, that's fine. The sheep got water. Sorry, they got water. They've got food as well, and that's okay. Chickens, they're doing okay. Ignore the productivities at 0%. That's because it's only just loaded in. The pigs have got water. They've got silage. So they're doing okay as well. Okay, great. Right, let's just get rid of that HUD and let's get rid of that. So we've probably got one more load off there. Hopefully no more than that, because I'm tired of doing... As I say, this is the third load we've got, but you'll see the quite impressive stack of grass we are now accumulated in the silage bin. One of the other things I want to do in this episode is go to O'Donovan's and purchase a... silage compactor, one of those spinning um, rollers with spikes, you know, some sort of like medieval death trap type thing. That's what we're going to use, and it's going to be great. Right, oh, that's a big old load, isn't it? Glorious day again in Glenmalure. Fantastic weather we've been having here this summer. What's our old financial state? 153,000. It's not bad. Oops. So it's a bit of a drive home, to be fair. But we can take a quick shortcut across a field in a short time. There's a track going around the edge of a field, which saves us a minute or two, which should be good. Look at the river as we drive over it. And this is the road we'll take. Is this the one? Yeah, this is the one. We could cut across the field, but there's a track going around it, so we'll go around the track. Because we don't actually own that field. Well, that's a really nice field. We could potentially buy that as well. What field is that? That is field 4. Okay, what's that? Is that Bank of Huggerstead? Oops. Okay. The tractor keeps driving if you press that, so we won't do that again until we're in a stationary position. So our barley's doing well, look at that. It's growing nicely. Coming to the back end of the farm, as you can see, the mountains of grass we have stacked up there. Look at that. Very impressive, I'm sure you'll agree. Right. Let's back this baby in. Can we back it on? Or is that as much far as it wants to go? No free space. Okay, great. So that side is full. So one of the things I want to do is just back this down. Let's go external view. And we'll back this onto the sheep to fill up there, but I'm not sure which one it is. So if we go in the middle of the two, I've got this trailer just going where it wants to go, to be honest with you. Alright, if we back it in between the two, then one of them should register it, shouldn't it? Yeah, there we go. There we go. Grass is not accepted. That's all they can take. We might as well do the pigs as we can cut through. See, their troughs look pretty full anyway, but might as well top them up. Excellent. Okay, that's topped up. Great. And that's gone top of the cows. And the rest we can dump on the other side and start a second silage bay. Okay, so the drive around here. Look at our other field, which is nicely going well. And this is where the cows are getting fed. Okay, and that's all maximum on the cows. Right, let's do a quick turnaround on the crops. I know this is not ideal. But there we go. Just the way it's got to be sometimes. And we're going to dump this in the backside of the silage sheet. We actually get two. So what we can do, we can go and get the medieval thing. And we can get that other one compacted down. And then we can get it tarped over and get it pickling. Oh yeah. What the hell? Oh, it straightened it up. Whatever happened there, it straightened it up there. I think Farming Sim 2000... Well, there we go. What are you doing? It seems to touch that wall and it all flips out majorly. Look at that. Okay. Won't do that then. Let's just back it up down the middle. Okay, that's as far back as it can go, so we'll start at the back and we'll just start dumping it down, bring it forward a little bit. Okay, and that is it done, empty, great. Right. So let's drive this back to the field and complete the, well, just tidy that field up. Good to know that we've got all the animals topped up with grass, so we don't have to worry about them going forward. We'll probably do another water run for the cows and the sheep, and we'll probably get the chickens done this time as well. We always negate the chickens, but yeah, you get very little benefit from them, but it's nice to have them. I will say that it is nice to have them. Let's just cut across here, save ourselves a little bit more time. There's nothing planted, so it should be fine. Ah, there. So we've still got that water meadow straight over, which we can still gut grass on there. So we've got so much land. And we've got another big field way over the back, which we haven't looked at yet in this playthrough. So yeah, we may even convert another meadow into an arable crop field, because as I say, we've got so much room. We are very lucky in this map. And the fact that grass grows incredibly quickly. That old adage of watching grass grow as being bored and or being something slow, not in this game. No, in Ireland they obviously have a very rich soil and it's very wet and it's but quite warm, and it seems to flourish like nothing on earth. Right. Chances are the truck's not coming. No, it's not. I think it's only the milk truck that uses this lane, so we don't have to worry too much about oncoming traffic. And we're back in this huge field. It's absolutely massive, isn't it, when you get into it. Make sure that's picking up. Yep, groovy. Probably don't have quite a full, another trailer in here, but we've got plenty. Probably more grass than we'll ever need, to be honest with you, but oh, I don't know, it's filling up quite quick, actually. Can I come turn tight enough to get onto this one? I think I probably can, you know. Oh yeah. Just weird view doing it that way. Okay, so we'll come down here and we'll pick up all the dregs we've missed. I seem to miss the dregs in quite a neat little row for me. Interesting. So we got two strips to go. Okay, how much? So we're up to 33%. So we are packing this in quite quickly, you know. I have been surprised. Okay, great. So yeah. We'll get these two rows picked up, and then we'll go take them back, dump them off, and we'll go and get the packer, and then we can go and get the first lot tarped over and pickling away. So we should be really happy with that. And then, what, should we just tidy up the water for the animals, or I don't know if I want to start the ploughing on this field just yet, because that's going to be a... That's going to be a big old task, isn't it? What I'll probably do is I'll probably set out the field I want and then let the AI do. Oh, what am I doing? I am bodging this up big style. Right, let's take a nice wide turning angle so we can turn in on it. I was just too busy trying to pick up all the little bits and didn't pay attention to try and line up the big one. Well, I'm not going to worry about that little patch. We'll just go for the big line now. Look at this field. Unbelievable. Plowing it is going to be a nightmare. That's why we're going to use the AI. Alright, we're going to get old Sebastian, bring him out of retirement after he managed to park this in the shed, the side of the shed last time. But we'll bring him out of retirement and he can prove his worth on plowing. If you've ever watched my agricultural planning, agricultural simulator 2013 with Sebastian's plowing, that's how he got introduced to me. You'll know what talents he has in the plowing area. Yeah, he plowed us a mountain range, which was absolutely amazing. Could never really get rid of it after that. Okay. So that is 91% full, and it's done. Done and done. Excellente. Right, really pleased with that. So that's that job done. We'll go and dump this back. Go and get the squisher and get it squished and tarped, as we said. Oof, this is all coming together nicely. All coming together nicely. Wow, with that, with almost a full load, that is really heavy because this tractor is chugging along. Chugging along. Chugging along. But it's doing okay. I say we've got 150 grand in the bank. After our next harvest of barley, we could actually sell the wheat we've got in the storage, thinking about it. I want to look to get a bigger... I want to get that big John Deere, basically, because it's all fancy and it's got all little fancy touches and stuff on it, and I think that's going to be our main tractor in this game. So that's what we might do. We'll sell the wheat, see how much we get for that, and then after the next barley harvest, when we get the money in, we will see where we are, and then we could potentially sell the yellow tractor and get the John Deere. That's what I'm thinking. Or we could sell the Sluter, but although the Sluter is a heavy duty tractor, and I know it costs a little bit on maintenance, but it's a good old tractor and it can do every job we want, you know. The little yellow one, it's a good tractor, it's a good medium sized tractor, but it can't do heavy tasks very well. So I'm thinking about trading that one in and keeping the Schluter for now, and then in time I want to get, you know, new tractors all around. Schluter's fine, but it's a bit heavy on the old maintenance front. Here we go. Poo pile is looking impressive. See, even this has got a bit of a struggle, pulling this load up the hill there. Who parked that trailer there, honestly? Right. The trailer that does not want to reverse, let's try and reverse it. Oh, there you go, it does want to reverse, it wants to turn really sharply. Well, that's okay. So let's just slowly bring that forward to try and keep it reasonably even. It doesn't really matter because we can then compact it and squish it about, which should then even it out a little bit better anyway. But should we just have a look to see how this is getting on? So that's got 33% fill level, that's fine. Okay, done. Done, done, and done. Right, I might try and park it in there if my reversing talents don't fail me. Go on baby, go back in there. You know you want to. Sure, that's not half bad. That'll do. Oh, I can't disconnect it. Why can't I disconnect it? Hello? Ah, I can disconnect it there. I push it in then? No. Okay, that's bad. Bad mistake. Don't do that again. Okay, so you can't park into the yard. I guess the potatoes or the sugar beet will spill over into those bays of the shed, so you can't actually park equipment in there. It's a bit of a shame. Well, you can park it in there, you just can't detach it from the tractor, so you'd have to leave the tractor there as well. But yeah, that's fine. We'll park it in its proper place. I was just trying to clear out the yard for a second so we can move some stuff about. But it's not nothing to worry about. Okay, it's just after lunch, let's come into O'Donovan's and buy ourselves a spiky round thing. I know I can do it by the menus, but I just like coming in here and buying. It just feels a lot better. Right, so we are after mods by brand, though. Mods by stuff. So it'd be a misc, I think. And it's that. 6,900. Buy, please. Happy days. There it is. Great. Look at that. That is awesome. That could do some serious damage in the car park, couldn't it? Oh, be like Robot Wars gone mental. That'd be awesome. But we're not going to do that because we are respectable, professional farmers. Or something. Okay. Those automated gates are brilliant. They just get out of the way just in time. Right, we'll start from this end, so we might as well compact the stuff. I'm just going to bring the menus up so I can see what it says. And that'll just help us do this bit. Right, so we want to drop that down. Do we want to do that? What do we want to do with it? We want to lower it down. We want to switch it on. Look at that. Make sure the dog's not anywhere near us. And just watch the compacting go. Okay, 29% compacted already. Whether it makes any real difference over just driving a tractor over it, I'm not so sure. But it certainly fits in with the more realistic model we are running with, and it certainly looks cool. And it evens it out nicely as well. %80-odd, %90-odd. It's good. Obviously, we're not going to tarp this one over just yet because we could add to it, and we've got other fields we can add to it. So. Lift that up for a second. This is the one we need to do. Might drop that down again. And let's go. So it's at 20. It's only 71% full. Oh, okay. It said we couldn't. Okay. Don't matter. Although it's only 70% full, we will tarp it over. We've got the other one to worry about as well. So that'll be fine for tarping over. Whoa! What happened there? Couldn't do that again. Oh, really? Right, let's try and lift that up and try and drive our way out of this. Can we drive our way out of this? No! Okay, let's reset that. Weird. Weird, weird, weird. Okay, reset. Schluter. Then you got to reset that. Right! There we go, we're back. We've jumbled bits of machinery all over the yard. What a mess, what a mess. We will do a little tidy up after we get this compacted. Alright, let's attack this from the other side. So we'll get this compacted, covered up, and then we'll tidy up the farmyard and we'll probably call it a day. Because I think we've done a good day's hard graft there. Wow, a shooter is really slow in reverse. All right, here we go. So up to almost 50% squishiness already. That's fine. Go back again. Got all the air out. Nice, 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 nice. Try not to go too near the edges because we know what happened last time. Some weird randomness physics glitch, rigid body spasm sent us off to the side. Could have been a nasty accident. Go 75%. Come on, almost there, almost there. Okay, almost 90%. Come on, last one. Come on, we'll get it this go. You watch, we'll get it, we'll get it, we'll get it. Five, 97, 98, go on, come on, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. Oh, 99, come on. Hey, 100, yay! Okay, so she's all compacted down nicely. So let's get that blanketed. There we go, look at that. Blacked up with loads of old tyres on it. That's exactly how you see him. Fantastic. So that'll start pickling away, and hopefully we'll have some silage in a wee while. Great. Right, let's just tidy up the farmyard then, and then we can call it a day. Then we're going to put the squisher there. Actually, no, let's put the squisher behind that. We do actually have a shed in there, which we don't use, but it's fine. Right, let's find some homes for this equipment. Do you know what? I might do this off screen. Yeah, it's not going to be the most exciting thing watching me tidy up the farmyard, is it? So I'll probably call it there, a day there, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. Thoughts and comments about what we should do going forward. I think we've got a fairly reasonably strong plan at the moment. Obviously, we'll get the Field 16 ploughed up and sown for canola, so we can sell it at that big price down at the lodge, and we should be earning big bucks when that comes in. And yeah, we'll look to get the tractor after the next grain harvest. Fantastic, that fits there beautifully, and there you go, the farmyard is looking nice and tidy, and we've got all we need. Yes, we'll collect the straw, we need the straw, and that's all good to go. Fantastic, and there you are, the beautiful silo covered over in a horrible grotty old black tarp and small tyres. Great stuff. So I'll leave it there, guys. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed this. Thoughts and comments please leave in the section below as I try and mount the wall with this tractor, and join me next time for more farming from Glenmalure. So I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.